EA Sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. And he's just one of those guys that if the game's on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
Reload! Check it! 220! Why can't we check?
Don't forget, work on installing your game plan prior to this week's matchup.
They ain't seen it when they young, out here grinding. It's okay, yeah. Either way, young, getting paid, yeah. I already mad at me cause it's popping. They don't wanna put some money in my pockets. It's okay, yeah. Either way, a hater always gonna hate, yeah. Mad at me cause I'm trying to feed my. I'm supposed to make it out and I don't bring my. I heard these always hating, said I'll never make it. I heard these always talking with them. It's okay, yeah. I heard he's mad at me cause I'm getting money. I heard he's mad at me.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
A good pickup there, a 22. Just the first quarter, but tackling going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent. And they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. Ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a long night.
They'll set up to throw. Flush to his right. Got some real estate inside the 30. That one good for 13 at a New England first down.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis, and he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. A look at the numbers last week for Deion Lewis. 12 carries, 135 yards, big game.
And the way they ran the ball last week has to bring a smile to the faces of the entire coaching staff, because not only are they seeing a back pile up yardage, they're seeing an offensive line in sync, and that bodes well this late in the season.
And his throw here is incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Third down, he'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he is out of bounds, but not before taking this inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
These type of plays are backbreakers for our defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
This is Lewis. And he keeps fighting his way into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Deion Lewis with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Pats have taken the early lead.
In as many coaches' meetings as we sit in, we hear the word finish.
We remind you that coming up later tonight, oh, this is going to be a good one. The Cowboys and the Raiders going at it in the East Bay.
Oh, that's old school right there.
Yeah, old school indeed. Then Monday night, another good late season matchup. The Falcons and the Buccaneers from Tampa to Deion Lewis. He's at the 40, past the 20, and all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis, his second touchdown of the game and his 9th on the year. So the Patriots coming out now, and they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But what about them just taking it? Big-time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call him the passing back. So they get him the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You talk about Kevin Falk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen. James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
Now they'll run with Lewis. Good cover defensively as they get to him just beyond the 45 after the juke. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Tackle on the run, and then just on the other side of midfield, they get to it. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with 3rd down and just 1 yard to go.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. Now a play fake here on 1st down. Going for the deep ball. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's 2nd down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield, but that's okay, because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you
pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. T.J. Watt in there to drop him, and that will go into the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, Parker. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Going up top. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's 4th down. And now out come the Patriots. And you know, their previous possession, they were able to move the football, but still wound up punting in the end.
You know, in 2016, Carolina had a 20-play drive that lasted over 10 minutes, And remember how it ended?
In a punt.
Yeah, I mean, how does that happen? You just don't see that happen every day.
This one maybe not quite that bad, but still, you'd like to have a chance for points if you hold the football that long.
Agreed.
Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
And especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw. And he will score. Touchdown, Patriots. It's their quarterback. A 13-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an...
Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Tight end three. Tight end three. Come on, let's go. Grand 38.
They'll set up a throw. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And that is caught. But the back judge right there to say incomplete. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
Where is this play going? Just keeping the play alive. Letting one. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And all the way in. Touchdown, New England. Rob Gronkowski in the final seconds of the first half.